What's up, everybody? I'm Seth Fowler, and today I've got a very special video. Today I'm here with the one and only SBMitch.
Hi!
He's the best. I've been watching his channel for a really long time. Basically, what he does is he unboxes mystery boxes, and I'll let you explain sort of what you do.
So, most of my boxes that I deal with on the channel are usually Soul Supremacy Beater boxes. And if some of you don't know what that is, it's basically a big old box of shoes, mystery sneakers, different sizes, different conditions that you flip for money because how they price these out is under market.
I figured this would be a cool change of pace for the channel, maybe try something different today and just introduce you guys to a really awesome guy if you don't already watch him. So if you want to check out his stuff, make sure to click the link in the description below. It'll be the first link. But I guess without further ado, let's just jump into it.
Sure. This box was $975 plus $40 to ship it here to our hometown of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania for a grand total of $1,015. And this is Seth's channel, so we're not going to do a breakdown or a report card. You can see that on my channel if you want, though. I haven't opened it yet. I never open these boxes ahead of time because that would just take the fun out of it.
It would. It really would. Before we open it, what do you expect to be in the box? Like, based off what you usually get, is there anything in particular you think is going to be in there?
In this price range, I mean, it really, really, it's really, honestly, a mystery. I don't know for sure. I have a feeling this could go one of either two ways. There could be a lot of really consistently good kicks,
right,
or a lot of really, really obscure, weird grade school sizes and one mega money shoe. We'll see what happens, I guess.
Oh, and all the shoes, will they be available on your website?
Yes, they will be available on my website. That website is called ransomnotesneakers.com on the internet.
Also linked below.
All right, this puppy is open. So when we get a pair without a box, we call them Lucy's. Shout out Stone Cold Kicks.
So, I do watch you too, Stone Cold. Your stuff is dope.
There are two loose shoes. Let's grab this first one. This is a size.
Is that a grade school?
It is. 7 youth. This is a Jordan 5. I don't know what, this might be fire red, but it's a grade school.
Yeah, so I don't know what it is.
Probably is a little bit different. No, I don't really have much to say about this. It's a grade school shoe, size 7.5.
How worn is it?
I mean, it's okay. I mean, the bottom is discolored, obviously, because fives are gonna be discolored. Cages are discolored.
Yep.
I mean, it's toe box creasing. It happens.
Yeah.
Can't imagine there's tons of value in here, which usually with loose shoes, there isn't really much value. So
what
both of them
are
here. This looks like probably 2014-ish.
Makes sense.
2011.
Oh wow. I have no idea what this is, but it's not bad.
Yeah, I guess. Jordan 5 grade school size, 7 youth.
What do you think it would go for? If you had to guess right now what it would go for, what do you think?
I always just undervalue grade school shoes. So my guess would be $65 maybe, tops.
Oh, nice.
Second shoe out, this is a recognizable one, I think.
Oh yeah,
this is a 2012 release. This is an Air Jordan 4. Looks like a military blue kind of colorway.
Yep.
The blue looks a little bit different than the old school military blue.
Does it also have some, like, I don't know if that, is that creasing or cracking in the midsole? What is that?
Probably cracking.
So it's been worn, but it's not terrible. It's got a rock in there, but.
Yeah, I mean, about the same condition.
$65, you think, or maybe?
Yeah, this is also a 7 youth, so it probably came from the same person.
Yeah.
You know,
2012
with fours, you're going to have cracking on the midsole. It's kind of inevitable, especially if it's a pair that's older than like 2.5 years. And it's a pair that you actually put on your feet and walk outside with them on, you know.
Cool.
Hi, Ben. Cool. All right. We got everything with boxes.
He's
this looks like
what the hell is going on over
this
here?
Looks like a small one, too. So this is a size 8 youth Air Jordan 1 Retro High OG.
Didn't you get like a Chicago one, like last box?
The last box, I got a 5.5 youth. That stock pair of Chicago 1s from 2015, they are already sold.
How much did it, if you don't mind me asking?
$675, $678, something like that.
Nice.
They sold on StockX. All right, this is some kind of weird.
What is that? Hyper Rose Black.
They're dead stock, so that's good.
That's great. It's got a fade on the back too, I didn't even notice that.
Yeah, the swoosh has got some interesting details right there.
Nice.
Size 8 youth. That means it's probably a gals release, which is totally cool. But yeah, these are definitely, yeah, dead stock.
Sorry.
Might be, oh, you're good.
Stupid name brand texting me.
It's a pink and black Jordan 1, all right. Probably not much value here. The retail on these was 95, so I would imagine probably about $50-$60.
Right.
But it's got the box, so that's good, and it's dead stock. Dead stock shoes will just move immediately because you can list them with ease.
Right, you can throw them on StockX, GOAT, whatever, yeah.
Exactly. A lot of youth shoes in here, let's keep going.
They really are.
There's a silver box SB. You can't plan this stuff, folks. This is a size,
a van.
Size 5 youth Air Jordan 2. Retro, if you can see it on there, it's got the old Q54 on it. We know exactly what these are.
Ooh.
And these are a dead stock pair. These are the Jordan 2 Kwai 54s.
I love that. I really wanted a pair of those in my size, but never got them.
People sleep on twos, man.
They really.
I love this fire too.
I love this. Just look at the details on that.
Yep. It's got like the creamy outsole with, you can see through the right there on the bottom. That's so sick.
Also dead stock. Size, what did I say, 5U? Mm-hmm. It's a little bit smaller, but again, with dead stock sneakers, easier to list and you can sell them almost immediately. So
what do you think those would go for?
These are probably about like 120 to 140 right now, I would imagine, depending on the smaller size. Grade school shoes, the prices on them are just kind of all over the place on the secondary market, so.
Nice.
Cool. More grade school Jordans. This is a size 7U, Air Jordan 7 Retro 30th VG. If I were a guessing man, I would say, this is probably Bordeaux's. No!
Oh, oof.
Barcelona Knights, y'all.
So far, are you happy with what you've picked up?
Yeah.
That's DS,
that
too.
That is DS.
That's great.
Yeah, they look like they've been unlaced.
140 retail.
Yeah. So there's that. It's a size 7 youth, Jordan 7, Barcelona Knights. You can see no wear on the bottoms. They've just been unlaced, which is totally fine because you can factory lace, which I showed in my last video.
I did watch that video, actually, yeah.
Sevens are cool. I'm not really a huge fan of sevens.
Yeah, I don't love that colorway either. It's not my favorite. It's, I mean, it's a black seven. You can't go wrong with it, but
yeah.
Like,
Sevens are, I don't know. I'm just not a seven guy. The only seven I've really seen and really liked was the Cigar Sevens, and that's basically it.
Those are sick.
Smaller size, but it's a bigger, smaller size, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
But it's dead stock too. Again, can't complain about dead stock shoes. I don't really
know. Supreme Vans, nice.
This is a half cab. No, it's a Lampin Pro Supreme Croc Suede size 8.
Oh, what?
Oh, these are actually really, really cool. These came out, this was a, I want to say spring, summer 18.
I've never seen these before in my life.
These look like they've been worn once. This is actually a really, really fire pair. It's got corduroy on the outsole, or on the upper.
I like the color too, the yellow is nice.
The black is like a croc. Kind of
like the Tiffany Tucks.
Yeah, these are actually really, really cool. I'm a huge fan of Vans.
Are they your size? Oh, size
8. Damn. No. One of the more interesting things about used sneakers is seeing what people put in here. Paper towels.
Sweet, that's disgusting.
I don't really know the value on these. I know retail was like 100 or something like that because it was a Supreme collaboration, but.
Your rule of thumb is 60% of, what's your rule of thumb for?
I would say this would probably be more like 80% because
80%?
It's very lightly worn. And I also clean shoes, so this could clean up really, really easily.
145 and a 9, so let's see, size 8. Oh, there isn't any size 8s.
Yeah, about 125, so maybe like 100 bucks, 110 bucks.
It's not bad.
These are very lightly worn. I'm having a love affair with these. These are really cool.
If they were your size, would you keep them?
Oh, absolutely, 100%. I'm a very big fan of anything yellow. So that's not a bad pickup.
Not bad.
This is a size 12 Jordan 11. I can already tell by the box what it is. Early 2018 release. A lot of people compared it to the Gamma 12s because they're kind of similar, but these are the cap and gown 12s. 11s, it's a size 12. They look like they've been worn a couple times.
Yeah.
The biggest thing that you can tell with 11s, obviously, the creasing. On the upper because it's patent leather and it should, I mean, you could walk once in these and you'd be like, oh, there's some creasing.
Yeah, the crease up.
These are very lightly worn. You can still see the Jumpman in here. It's still got the inserts, which is pretty awesome. Feels like a premium Jordan. You could wear this casually or formally if you wanted to, so.
And it really does look just like a Gamma. It's like, so, except for the Jumpman and the outsole is a slightly darker color, but it's very similar.
It's got this really low pile suede.
Oh yeah, it does.
The 23 and the Jumpman are different. That's literally the only thing that's different about these. But these are still a fire pair.
I wonder if these were worn to prom and that was it.
Size 12.
Very cool. How much do you think these would go for if you sold them right now?
Size 12? Mm-hmm. My guess would be probably around 250-ish. Nice. Not too bad.
I'm gonna guess this is a Space Jam based on 2009.
Size 10. It's gonna be really hard not to keep.
It's in pretty decent condition too. That's solid.
Wow.
Wow, there's like no creasing on them either.
These are in awesome shape. I mean, it's a almost 10-year-old shoe, so there's gonna be yellowing on the outsole.
There's only slight creasing there on the lateral side and a little bit on the medial side, but that's it. Is there anything inside it? No.
No insoles or anything. Jumpman's been worn off, but that's okay. I mean, that's what happens when you put your feet in shoes and move around in them.
And it's the old one with the butt crack too.
Yes. Cool, this is a really good pickup actually.
Definitely.
These still go for over 300 bucks. Size 11 and a half is a pretty rare size to find too, so that's pretty cool.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that's exciting. What I think it is.
Yeah.
This next one, if it's my size, this is a really tough one. So we're still, okay,
size
good.
Eight and a half.
Sticking with the Jordan 11 theme, mm-hmm. Can't tell by the box. It's a big old gray box. This is a 2010 release of a Jordan 11, cool gray.
I had a pair of these.
These are worn.
Pretty heavy, right? No, not terribly.
I mean, they just need to be cleaned up. That's the nice thing is you can beautify these things.
Yeah.
They'll be good to go. Plus, it just kind of warms my heart to see shoes that are worn. Just because I know someone put them on their feet and made some memories in them. Cool.
These really are nice. I love the cool grays. They're so... I need them to retro these. I mean, I need the breads first, and then we can get these.
The breads are on the way.
So. They are. I'm soaked.
Woo! Yeah, I would say these are probably between like 260 and 270.
These ones smell a little bit, just a tiny bit.
Tiny bit.
It's not bad.
Yeah.
I never thought of smell being a thing. I guess because I've only ever watched the video. Do you ever get any like bad smelling shoes?
Every once in a while.
Yeah.
There was a pair of Dunk Highs, the Huxtables, that just were beyond saving. And that's just kind of what happens with it. That's sometimes you're going to have that in the beater box.
Yeah, makes sense.
Cool. This is a really good size, really good shoe.
How quickly do you think that'll move?
Probably within a week, honestly.
Sweet.
So this last one, this is not planned. If you don't know, the SB in my name stands for skateboard, as in Nike skateboarding. This is a Dunk, Nike Dunk skateboarding.
Size 11 and a half.
Size 11 and a half, which is kind of my size. I think I know what they are.
Oh my God! That's so nuts.
This is definitely the money shoe.
You should keep those. You should 100% keep those.
These are the Heineken Dunk Lows. I remember in 2005 camping for these.
I've never held a pair of these before. Are you, okay, so real question. Are you keeping these?
Yes.
Yeah, you 100%
I am keeping these. These, in a dead stock condition, these still fetch over $1,000.
Oh, sure.
This is crazy.
There's a little bit of heel drag, but it's not bad. Yeah, that's crazy. And you can rock these, dude. That's so nuts. What would you have done if this was like three sizes too small? Would it have sucked, or would you have been fine because you could have sold it?
I've been fine with it because I know tons of people in the SB community that I could, you know, hook these up with. But
right. Wow.
Again, weird stuff in the insoles. It's a plastic Nike bag. Interesting. This is a classic SB. This is a very important sneaker if you're an SB fan. During the mid-2000s, Nike SB was in their heyday, and this is one of the very iconic pairs from that era.
Back when I used to do custom sneakers, I'd paint a lot of the Heineken stars on the back of shoes.
Nice.
And they're in good condition, too.
Yeah, I think these are actually ceased and desisted because of the copyright infringement type thing.
Yep.
Wow. Cool.
That's so sick.
I did not expect that. This is... Good job, Soul. Wow.
It's like they knew that this box was for you.
I hope so.
That's so sick. So how much do you think the entire box is worth?
I think this box is probably, I mean, we paid $975, so I mean, the value on this is probably well over $1,300.
That's solid.
That's just guessing though, so I don't really know.
And I'll have Mitch actually put up the final value right here so you guys know if his prediction was right.
I'm wrong a lot, so no promises.
Well, guys, that pretty much wraps up the video for today. Thank you so much, Mitch, for coming out.
Thanks for having me, man. This is awesome.
Of course. I appreciate it. If you guys want to see more videos just like this, I won't be doing any more videos like this, but every time that Mitch gets a box, he posts a video on his YouTube channel. So if you guys want to check that out, make sure to head on over to his channel, link in the description below. Make sure to sub. And again, if you want to grab any of the sneakers that he has for sale, go to his website.
This Friday at 6 o'clock p.m. is when I restock. Every Friday.
Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one.
Thanks, everybody, and thank you, Seth.
Yeah, of course, man. Pleasure.